Welcome back, students. Let's continue our session with the central nervous system. As I have told you in earlier session that central nervous system has two main organs involved in this. First is the brain and second is the spinal cord. Now, brain and spinal cord are connected with all sense organs of the body and as well as other parts of the body by millions of nerves. And brain is located inside the skull of our head, while the spinal cord, it is a very thick nerve which runs inside the cavity of our backbone inside our body. Okay, so now what is the main function of the central nervous system? Central nervous system directs the incoming messages to the motor neurons to the part of body which responds to the stimulus. That means central nervous system enables a person to give more appropriate and more intelligent response to various situations. Now, by using central nervous system, a person can vary his behavior according to the situations. Okay, now let's start with the first organ, that is human brain. As I've told you, human brain is inside our head, and it is inside the cranium. Inside the cranium, that is nothing but a bony box in the skull which protects our brain. Right, now this brain is surrounded by a number of membranes which are called as meninges, which protect the brain from the mechanical shocks, you can say. Now, pairs of cranial nerves arrive from the brain. These, you can see, they are nothing but the cranial nerves of a brain. Now, brain is mostly divided into three regions, that is forebrain, midbrain and the headbrain. Now, the forebrain consists of the cerebrum. Mostly it is cerebrum is also called as forebrain. Okay, now that is the main thinking part of our brain. Next comes the midbrain, which is not further divided into any divisions, and lastly comes the hindbrain. It consists of the three centers, that is pons, medulla and the cerebellum. Okay, now we'll discuss the functions of forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. Now, you know, the cerebrum or the forebrain is a main thinking part of the brain. It is a site of our faculties such as learning, reasoning, intelligence, personality, memory, etc. Not only those, are sensations, actions, movements are controlled by the cerebrum. And the cerebrum has different areas for performing different functions. Okay. Next comes the midbrain. And you can also say that all voluntary actions of our body are coordinated by the cerebrum. Next comes the midbrain. Okay, midbrain controls the reflex movements of our head, neck, trunk in response to the visual and the auditory stimuli. It also controls, you know, the reflex movements of the eye muscles, changes the pupil size and also the shape of the eye lenses. And next comes the hindbrain. The pons takes place, you can say, in regulation of the respiration. Next comes the cerebellum, which helps in maintaining the posture and balance of our body and also enables to make the precise, accurate movements, you can say. Next comes the medulla. Medulla controls the various involuntary actions such as heartbeat, I can also say the blood circulation, breathing, blood pressure, and also the peristaltic movement of our oesophagus. So this was all about the human brain. Next comes the spinal cord. As I have told you, it is a thick nerve which is in the vertebral column of the body. And this spinal cord mainly controls all the, you can say, the reflex actions, or you can say it also conducts the nerve impulses of our body. The spinal cord begins with the continuation, that means from the upper side it is connected with the brain and it is enclosed by a bony cage, as you can see the vertebral column here. Okay, and it is also surrounded by membranes called as meninges, and there are 31 pair of nerves arise from the spinal cord. As I've told you, that spinal cord main function is with the spinal reflex actions and conduction of nerve impulse to and from the brain. So these were the organs of the central nervous systems. Thank you.